will be accepted from him. Meaning يوم القيامة. وهو في الآخرة. And he will be, meaning in the hereafter, he will be among the losers. He will be among those who will be upon the state of lust. والعياذ بالله. So therefore the definition of Islam, as alhamdulillah all of us should memorize, it is not Islam mean peace. Or Islam is taken from salam. Or Islam is taken from this, as you know, these people of rhetoric, these people of kalam, they will be always mentioning things that barakallahu fi far away removed from the truth. So here the Sheikh Hafi rahimahullah is schooling us in regard to what is the definition of Islam, which is وهو الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد والانقياد له بالطاعة والخلوص والبراءة من الشرك وأهله. طيب أبو جليل. إسماعيل. الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد. ابن والانقياد له وال والبراءة من الشرك. أبا إبراهيم. Page number 44, for those who have my print. What page is that, Ismail, on yours? 40. 40? أركان الإسلام. أركان الإسلام خمسة. The five pillars of Islam. The five pillars of Islam. Now, without looking at the text, I want two hadith that is sarahatan showing those without looking. Two hadith that is talking about the five pillars of Islam. Aba Munira. Ahsanta, the hadith of Ibn Umar. Tayyib, what was the hadith? Ba. Bu. B. I'm giving you an option. Ba, B, Bu. That's the starting, one of them. I'm giving you the second word, Ni. Ahsanta. That Islam is built upon five. Islam is built upon five. Ahsanta. Buniya al-Islam ala khams. That Islam is built upon five. The other hadith. Ahsanta, the hadith of Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. Started with what? How did the hadith of Jibreel started? We should memorize this in Arabic first. How the hadith of Jibreel started? Abu Zura? Hey, that's your talking. That's your kalam right there. That's not what the hadith said. You got it. You want a hint? You want a hint? Yeah, say it. You write it. Say it. No, I say in Arabic. I didn't say English. You got it though. I just heard you say it. Say it. Say it. أحسنت بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم إذ تلا علينا رجل إلى آخر الحديث. We spend a lot of time, alhamdulillah, dealing with the hadith. على كل the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنه وارضاه. May Allah be pleased with him and his father and all of the Sahaba رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين. He said, قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Abdullah ibn Umar, he was from the, also the Abad al-Arba. He was from the four Abdullah. This is important, Barakallah. When we read the likes of this, we always, alhamdulillah, remember the details, you know, in these issues. He said, بني الإسلام على خمس, that Islam is built upon five. That Islam is built upon five. Islam is built upon five, meaning the five pillars of Al-Islam. He mentioned the testimony of there is none worthy of worship but Allah. There is none worthy of worship but Allah. And Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is his messenger. The second one is the establishing the salah. Number three, ita is zakat, giving the zakat. Number four is to perform the pilgrimage. Wasawm Ramadan, and fasting the month of Ramadan. And fasting the month of Ramadan. But there is a issue here that the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he wanted to put a note with, which is the taqdeem al-hajj ala sawm. That there is some other narration where that the fasting, طيب, here that the hajj, barakallahu feekum, is being mentioned before the issue of fasting. But, and which is, barakallahu feekum, agreed, طيب, on in regard to the book of Imam Bukhari and Muslim. In regard to Imam Bukhari and Muslim, may Allah have mercy upon them. May Allah have mercy upon them. But there is another riwayah that Imam Muslim rahimahullah brought, whereas وَأَمَّا تَقْدِيمُ الصَّوْمَ عَلَى الْحَجِّ فَهُوَ إِحْدَى الرِّوَايَةِ Imam Muslim, from Imam Muslim. As in regard that the fasting to be mentioned before the Hajj, this is one of the riwayah from Imam Muslim. These two prints, they have differences, right? This was the first print. So I think that's the second version or the third print. But ala kullin, the prints, they, alhamdulillah, they differ. So Imam Muslim, rahimahullah, he has a hadith, whereas the fasting was mentioned before the issue of the Hajj. But also, this hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar, that you realize that Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim, they agree upon this. Imam Muslim, he has a hadith that he mentioned, barakallahu feekum, whereas that the Hajj was mentioned second, fifth, before Ramadan. Tayyip. So on my print page 45, all right. So he mentioned this hadith. He could have mentioned many more hadith, like the hadith of Jibreel and the likes of that, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked by Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, what is Islam? And he told him Islam is, and he mentioned these five things. So, yep. So the other issue, barakallahu feekum, we'll deal with tonight is Nawaqid al-Islam ashara. Nawaqid al-Islam ashara. The 10 nullifiers of al-Islam. The 10 nullifiers of al-Islam. We will mention first what Sheikh Fawzan Hafidhahullah mentioned in his explanation of Nawaqid al-Islam, which is that Muhammad ibn al-Wahhab, rahimahullah wa iya, he mentioned these 10 because of they were the 10 Nawaqid al-Islam that was more rampant during his time. Because this was the Nawaqid al-Islam that people were more involved in during his time. They were more prevalent during his time. Not to mean that there are only 10 things that will nullify the religion. La. But he said, rather, if you go to the books of fiqh, that you will see many more, barakallahu fi, in regard to the Nawaqid al-Islam. But here, he only recorded these 10 that was more prevalent during his time. Meaning this was very obvious. This was very seen during his time. Tayyip. So likewise, these 10 that Shaykh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab al-Wasabi brought, that's the same one that Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah al-Tamimi has brought. Right? Al-Tamimi. Right? Al-Tamimi. Right? Al-Tamimi. Right? You all remember the hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. As the Messenger mentioned, alayhi salatu wasalam, that those who will be the hardest one against the Dajjal will be the from the Banu Tamimi. Allahu Akbar. Those who will be the hardest one against the Dajjal will be from the tribe of At-Tamimi, where Muhammad, Shaykh al-Islam, Muhammad ibn al-Wahhab al-Mujaddid, he is from that tribe. May Allah have mercy upon him. Ameen. Who else is from the tribe of the Tamimi, from the Sahaba? We mentioned it one time. They mentioned that Abu Hurairah, the ulama mentioned that Abu Hurairah also is from the Tamimi. طيب على كل در نواقض الإسلام عشرة, the 10 nullifier of Islam. النقض الأول, the first nullifier, is الشرك بالله, is الشرك بالله, ascribing partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Get your hands up. Is ascribing partner with Allah. And he mentioned وذلك أن يجعل, and it is that you place بينه وبين الله, it is that the person will place between him and Allah وصائط, a intermediary or a something between him and Allah. يدعوهم, that they will be calling on him or calling on them, معذرة, they will be calling on them. ويسألهم, and they will be asking them, meaning beseeching on them. What? الشفاعه, asking them intercession. Right? They will be placing, it is that you are placing, or they are placing that which between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, an intermediary. يدعوهم, calling upon them. ويسألهم الشفاعة, and asking them for the intercession. ويتوكل عليهم, and they will be relying upon them. And they will be likewise, barakallahu fikum, seeking yani protection from them. And they will be likewise yani vowing for on their behalf. They will be vowing for them. And they will be also they will be also doing that which causes what? The slaughtering. ويذبح بإسمهم. They will be slaughtering on their names. Right? And all of this, barakallah, it is something that we see in our daily life in the society. I'm not talking about in the society of the disbelievers. I'm talking about in the society in the Muslim lands. This is easily you find people asking shafa'a, tayyib, for someone that is barakallah fikum, number one. And as we will dwell into that later on, bi'ithnillah, that the condition of shafa'a is not that individual doesn't even meet one of the conditions of shafa'a. Tayyib. So therefore, here, that we see this in our society, where people be calling other than Allah, calling them openly and not even be shy about this, but rather calling on other than on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyib. And likewise, seeking protection and seeking assistance and aid and assist and protection on them. And likewise, making vows for them and also be slaughtering in their names. And he mentioned, if that they will be having yani that belief by in regard to daf'u ad-dar, yani removing harm, aw jalb al-naf', or bringing about good things, and he say it is min dunillah, besides Allah, faqad kafara, whoever does this having the belief that they will bring to you good and they will wave away from you harm, he say other than Allah, whoever does this has indeed disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many times you find individual, barakallahu fikum, they will wear a big old ring, or they will wear a big old bracelet, where they will stuff it up with amulets and the like. So you thinking about that this amulet will wave away from them evil or harm, or it will be bringing good to for themselves. Whether they be wearing the lucky charm or the necklaces and the likes of this, all of this, barakallahu fikum, it is in regard to ash-shirku billah wal-iyadu billah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah An-Nisa, قال الله تبارك